Hello everyone, and welcome back to my complete stock run-through of Kerbal Space Program 0.23. And here we are with Merman Kerman on Minmus, testing out a system that is meant for Drez, and possibly Joule. So far, I mean, we've had a failure, but this time it worked fine. And we've done all our experiments, so everything is set to go for our return journey back to Kerbin, and then we can set off for possibly Drez. I'm more comfortable sending the system to Drez than to Joule right now. But I'll see. Because remember, Joule is in the right position. I would have to time warp in order to get into position for Drez. But first things first, let's get Merman Kerman and his buddy up in orbit back to Kerbin. Alright, so let me get the... Oh, come on. There we go. Retract the ladders, and then SAS on. And we have to rendezvous with the other stage in orbit. So, without further ado, I think we are ready to go. Oh, I know what I forgot. We need to actually match up with it, right? But we haven't been here for long, so it shouldn't be too far off. Let's see. Okay, well, first of all, can we cut that out for a sec? And let's say... we are pretty far off, actually. See, what you need to do is wait till your position actually hits this orbit. Let's get in line. So you see this straight line here? Our position should have been in line with that. But no matter, I think I can fix this. Something like this will do. Minmus is easy for this sort of thing. I sense something close. Quite there. I think that's very good. That's as good as I'm gonna get right now as far as a smaller orbit that can eventually rendezvous with it. I could probably nudge it in. These two are reasonably close. No, that's a good idea. The quicker the better, because that'll take fewer orbits to adjust to it. Okay, so we're just waiting for the peak there, and then we'll thrust the rest of the way. I've been playing with the realism overhaul stuff, and that's a different story altogether. Because now they've put Engine Igniter in the mix, and I'm having a lot of fun with Engine Igniter, actually. Because you have limited number of times that you can ignite your rockets, and you also have to make sure that the fuel is properly situated, because if it's just flowing around in a tank, then it's not going to actually get into the fuel lines, and they actually simulate that. So you use RCS to push the fuel into the back so that it'll be fed into the rockets before lighting the rockets. That gets to be a lot of pain and suffering, but anyway, we don't have to worry about that. And yeah, let me just... No. Okay, we seem to be completely on the opposite sides of everything from our target. Oh dear. We're going in the wrong direction. Ahahaha. In this case, that's not a problem, but I really must remember not to do that again. In this case, I can fix it. Shall I just fix it completely? No. No, I'll do the tricky business of fixing it right when we rendezvous. Because I've got a lot of spare fuel now. This lander was meant for more than just Minmus. Okay, so let's say around here I try and doesn't want to admit that I can do it. Oh well. Let's find out. I don't think I've ever tried this before. So you're getting something new from me. So we're going in opposite directions and I have to flip, basically. Let's see. Now, don't try to do this anywhere except for Minmus. Really, it's no good. But Minmus, you can do this. So now we should be going in the same direction. We're pretty far apart right now. Let me bring my orbit in. Start plotting for a far side intercept, you know, intercept right here. Some of this just takes practice. Some of it takes luck. There we go. And some of it takes not passing the maneuver node every time you need to burn. Okay, so let's meet up with it. Everything else can be done from out here. It's very agile, so I think I might have put one reaction wheel too many on this thing. Well, yeah, I can. I'm gonna use RCS for the rest of the way, so if I wasn't gonna use RCS for the rest of the way, controlling from there would not be a good idea because rockets would be pointing the wrong way. And everything would be bad. Now the reason we have somebody in the other one is so I can orient it properly and save myself some headache. That's really the only reason the other guy's there, otherwise we could have done this all on our own. Okay, so let me switch to him. And do that thing. Wildred Kerman, I forgot his name before. Wildred Kerman needs to do. Okay, looks like everything's good. I think that's within the realm of where docking port magnetism should work. There we go. All nice and neat. Alright, so I need to turn off these guys. I really should have action grouped that. I'll have to make a note of that later to action group these so I can turn them off at this point. Alright, so we're back on the nukes. Plenty of fuel because, of course, this was not meant to just go to Minmus. And we can't target Kerbin because we're already around it. Somewhat eccentric, somewhat inclined orbit, but nope, wrong way. Should be a smooth deal to Kerbin. That's not quite what I want. We're going around the wrong way, that's why. This way. That's what we want. Good, good. Then adjust to make sure that the outgoing path is in the same direction. It is in the opposite direction of Mimus' path. And all will be well. Now, I have to actually get into orbit around Kerbin. I don't know exactly the altitude that that would be good for. Because, remember, this stage has to stay in orbit. You know, maybe I should simulate not doing that. In other words, what about the case where I don't actually make orbit? We could use the whole alternative situation where I decouple from here and bring this portion back down, and then parachute them down separately. That could result in some weird weird issues with the physics range, I'm not sure. Yeah, I think I might do that, but let's get around Kerbin first. Whoa, I'm controlling from the wrong direction. I betcha. Say control from here. Yep. So notes for when I go to Drez: first, fix the staging. Second, make sure that when I launch off of Drez, I am going in the same direction as the nuclear stage. And then, what was the third thing fix? I just mentioned it. Oh well, I'll figure it out in VAB. Okay. Well, there's Kerbin hiding right there, so let's just point prograde. See where it takes us. See you around Kerbin orbit. Okay, there's no deadly re-entry, but there is atmosphere, so let's retract our solar panels. The only thing that really gets affected by the atmosphere these days, it seems. Okay. So, again, we're trying to get into orbit, but... yeah, let me try and get into orbit, and then I'll deorbit and try out the alternative plan where I decouple from here and bring both of them back down at the same time. That's also an abort test, right? Because if in the case of an abort where the launcher has an issue, that's the same thing. I have to decouple from here and bring them both down at the same time. So that's a valuable test to do. We might be using the same system not only for Drez but for a Joule mission, so gotta give it a decent shakedown. Alright, well, I don't really need this view right now. We're going in as we are going in. Nope, we're going back up again. How far did it take us? Oh, well, pretty decent. I think by the time we're out of the atmosphere, we'll be in an orbit. Of course, we'll have to lift this end. And by orbit, I mean, you know, something normal instead of something eccentric. Even right now, this is fine as long as we boost that back up. But I'll bring it below 1 million meters. Okay, that's good enough. Let me go around. Okay, we'll call that safely in orbit. Actually, this can won't be much use just sitting here. Yeah, I do want to actually deorbit it. So maybe safely in orbit is not what we're doing this time. Let's actually deorbit this whole thing. And I'll actually have it striking the planet. So I have that striking the planet, and I'm going to decouple here. And now it's just this part. I'm going to reactivate these engines. That's the other thing I wanted to do. I wanted to action group these. And here's another time when that'll be helpful. It's always nice to have three things to do back in the VAB once you return. That seems to be the case this time. Alright. So, what I want to do is actually not be crashing into the ground here. And I don't want to be aiming at the other portion of this, so I'm going to actually tilt down a bit. Yes, that should be fine. Now that would be a re-entry profile that would make even deadly re-entry happy, except of course the no heat shield or anything. Now, this way around. Now I have to get come to grips with my parachutes. How much does this weigh? 6 tons. I don't think the chutes are good enough for 6 tons. Otherwise, I pop them all and maybe dump it at the last second. Should probably action group this thing, too. I'm gonna have these chutes separated. I don't know if that's a good idea or not. If I pop all of them at the same time, will they snap because there's too much weight? I mean, we're talking about when we're in drag mode. Perhaps not. I'm gonna stage them here then. I don't know what that stage is for. Well, Merman and Wilfred seem confident, so that's nice to see. Well, I mean, Wilfred is probably feeling quite hot right now. Fortunately for him, we don't know how hot. I'm sure I've done temperature scans here before. Yeah. Barometer. Oh, actually, I haven't done a barometer, because, you know, I never seem to manage to do a barometer reading when there's a reason to. Well, okay, keep that data. Okay, I'm going to put these chutes out on a separate stage. And I am going to give them a try right now. Right. Gotta turn SAS off. And now I'm going to... Yeah, I'm going to decouple Wilfred. I'm going to switch to Wilfred, and I'm going to deploy his shoots. Oh, that could have been bad. Well, that is important to know. And then I'm going to... decouple this. Okay, are we all... Uh-oh. Okay. Okay. This is... Okay, so like this. So now I have to make sure they both have their chutes deploy, I think. They're coming in pretty close together. I think Wilfred's is upside down. Don't know why. I keep going to this one. It's probably because it was knocked like that. There we go. SAS. Yeah, it can work. Okay. So which one's higher? This one's higher. So I have to pay attention to this one first. I don't know. That decoupling and knock did not look good. Maybe I should do it higher or lower? I don't know. Maybe I should have Wilfred release his chutes at the same time this does. But then they'll even be closer together. Wait a little while before popping Wilfred shoots. Maybe. That's gonna have a smash. Yeah. Oh, what? I'm no longer in range of Wilfred. Uh-oh. Map view. Crud. I'm no longer in physics range of Wilfred. Yeah, Merman's happy. I don't think I can... Is there another vessel there? Anyway, you look at it, they have to be so close together. I don't know. I think Wilfred just popped out of existence. Well, we'll find out. I might have to rethink the whole keeping another Kerbal down there. I don't think it's strictly necessary. Just to orient the craft. Docking was pretty easy. And if we're going to Drez, you know. We might have lost Wilfred to physics. I mean, the mission itself is fine. It should have worked. He had his parachutes out. He should have survived. But the peculiar physics of Kerbal Space Program, where it only renders in a 2-kilometer-ish range, might have gotten him. Okay, well let's recover Merman Kerman first. So here we are, 575 science is not too shabby. Of course, our first landing on Mimis, so that's why we got so much. And actually, there's plenty of other landings we could do on Mimis, because biomes, so. Actually, recovery of vessel return from the surface of Mimis is not bad either. But you know what I'm thinking. I'm thinking, what happened to Wilfred? So let's go to the crew center and the astronaut complex and see what's what. Yeah, we lost Wildred. And we lost Wildred to the physics range, so I'm not gonna take too much responsibility for that. That is, Because my mission, as constructed, should have gone fine. And, of course, we could have done the thing where we left him in orbit. We were just testing the abort mechanism, and that was the issue. So, yeah, the mission could have gone right, and it was just the peculiarities of Kerbal Space Program that made it weird. Alright, while we're here, let's find some more willing volunteers. They're volunteers now because I don't think we have a mechanism to pay them. But I always like low stupidity and high degrees of courage. And I guess high degrees of stupidity too. Jordan. We've got a lot of missions to conduct, so we might as well stock up. I think this is good for now. I can't remember too many names at the same time anyway. Alright, so let's fix up our craft. So I've come to the conclusion that I would rather carry more RCS fuel than to make sure that I can dock with this portion than risk an extra Kerbal life. So I'm just going to dump that. We will have this be a single Kerbal mission. While we're like this, though, it seems like we could... how much did this weigh? 0.66. Not much. But just to extend this a little bit so that we're not too close to these two pods, I think I've got to go like that. I think that makes me feel a little bit better. Though, actually, having that knot there would make it look better. Because it's all tighter and everything. But I don't like the docking situation there. Okay, like I said, we had plenty of RCS, though. I would expect that I could dock with this anyway. Okay. Oh, right. So the other things I needed to do. Action group these. That's the panel, so these will be there. Action group two. I guess while I'm at it, I should action group the ladders. Oh, no. Anything else I need to action group? I don't think so. You know what I could... well, I mean, that would be excessive. RCS tanks here. Why? I don't see why. Okay, what else did I have to do? A staging. Well, staging is actually a little bit more interesting now, isn't it? Because I got rid of that pod. So these two, that's fine. Oh, I want to action group this. So that'll be four. Undock. And again, I would like to disable fuel crossfeed through this. That's not an option though. The rest is actually just fine now. I don't really ever want to have those two drop off. We're going to call this something different. Let's call this Lambda 2. Was there anything else I needed to fix before we send this over to Drez? There might be some sort of structural issue here now that I've removed the pod and added this tank. I don't know if it's quite as structurally sound as the pod. Now, of course, I don't need so many struts. We found that out. But where to remove them from? I mean, these externals are very tenuous. They provide so much thrust to the whole thing, and they're sticking so far out that I hesitate to mess with them. Kerbal joint reinforcement, of course, would fix this, but this is... I guess I can get rid of these. The rest, I think, is necessary for now. I could actually just put one of the double tanks in here. Do I have those yet? Yeah. But I think this is fine. Let's try this out going to Drez. But I need to do some time warping, so let's leave it in the VAB for now and go out to the tracking station to time warp to the right position for a transfer to Drez. Okay, so here we are with Merman Kerman's newly planted flag on Minmus, and for some reason I can't change my camera. I can't move it around or anything, but that's alright. We do not need to do such things, so let's just see. We need to time warp such that Drez, over here, is in a 82 degree angle with Kerbin. So draw a line from Kerbin to the sun to Drez, and right now we're more like 180 degrees, but Kerbin will eventually catch up. So let's time warp. I don't really need this up, but anyway. Time warp until Kerbin is 82 degrees. Which should be like a little bit more than a month kind of thing. We are missing our Joule encounter, but those will come. We will have other opportunities for that. And it is Drez that I've never been to before. So that's right about 90. And let's say protractor. Protractor time. And actually that's less. That's less than what I was looking for, but it shouldn't be too far off, so let's go with it. Okay, to the launch pad with our new rocket. Okay, so much as I like Merman Kerman doing everything... Oh, Wildred's back. Oh, because Time Warp, I guess they regenerate too? I thought only the orange guys regenerated. Oh, anyway, we're not doing Bill, but how about one of the newbies? Jongen. No, I don't like that. Gurdon. Seanbro. Derlin. Melzer. Derlin Kerman has a sort of ring to it. Lots of courage. All right. Derlin Kerman, and yeah, let's launch him on the Lambda 2 then. Whoa, physics is not treating this rocket well, but F3 is good to go. SAS is on, throttle up, and yeah, Derlin looks fine, so let's launch this thing. This thing. Okay, a rare case where I don't burn for orbit in one go. I often do, but this is an interplanetary journey that requires a bit more finesse. And I actually want to have my periapsis be where I aim to launch for Drez, which means I want my periapsis roughly around here. Can I do that? Yeah, and I want my periapsis lower. Get as much benefit out of Overgrowth effect as possible. Don't think I can do much. Oh, no, wait. I think I can do that. No, it'll still be relatively circular. Okay. Well, that's good enough. Nobody ever complained about circular orbit. Unless you're trying to transfer to something, I guess. So there it is, and we can start now, I think. Whoa! That was a kick to it. Oops. Okay, now, aiming for Drez. Going to my new maneuver node a little bit off from the periapsis because I know I'm going to need it that way. And we've got a long way to go. Yeah, actually a lot from there. Oh, we could have probably burned immediately. Oop, that's actually passing it by quite a lot. Oh, we need a plane change. Come on, you. Oh, we've already passed it. Ha. Oh, okay. The trouble with plane changes when you're trying to burn to a different planet is that you don't necessarily know where your ascending and descending nodes are immediately. You know that they're there, but not quite right now. And there's no way... there's no way I can fix it right now. I'll just have to have a little bit of faith that if I hit the orbit, I'm going to... I should get an encounter of some kind. Part of the problem is that Drez itself doesn't have much of a gravity. It's also got a somewhat eccentric orbit. If you can see, it's much closer to the sun on this side than on this side. Lots of interesting problems that mean that it's not gonna... Well, it's gonna cause issues for me, say. Oh wait, we've got one there, but boy is that not optimal. that's more of a quick transfer. You can see we're bulging out here, and that's not going to be what I want to do. Interesting though. If we could get that one a little bit more at our apoapsis here, that'd be fine. But no, it seems like that makes it farther apart. We can have an encounter there. I don't think it's the best thing to do. Yeah, this definitely looks like not the best thing to do. How about I just burn out of Kerbin's sphere of influence and then make some plans? No, not that plan. Make sure I'm lined up with Kerbin's own orbit. Oh, this is tweaky. Okay. So something like that for a beginner, and then after that we'll adjust as necessary. It's mostly going to be a plane change, right around the ascending node there. Okay, so let's do this burn first. I guess I could plot both. I don't know if that'll work out right. Let's say I do want to plot both and add a maneuver here. Oh, we're not quite far enough. Okay, now that's probably not the right place. Let's say we go a little bit further. Add a maneuver here. Let's bring us down. Aha, aha. There we go. And a little bit of tweaking should take care of that. Yep, there we go. Finally got an encounter with Drez. Alright, so let's try and make this as accurate as possible. And you know how I am with maneuver nodes. I'm not very accurate with them. So let's try our best this time though. Derlin Kerman. Okay, I think we should go. Make sure we're not dipping back into the atmosphere. And it doesn't look like we are. We're aligned excellently. And this is pretty close to our apoapsis, so I don't expect that there's going to be much... Well, there's going to be some speed that we need to burn off. Obviously, Drez doesn't have an atmosphere and we can't aerobrake around it, but it's not going to be horrible. It's going to be about as good as we can get it. Alright, so I'll catch you at the end of this burn. Okay, so here we are, coming up on the last bit of our burn, and I just want my apoapsis around the sun to be the same as what I had planned. Okay, that's good enough. Let's see now. Let's get rid of this. And now this is no longer anywhere near what I want it to be, but we can fix that. Hopefully. Maybe. Oh, it's even better than I thought. Good, good. There we go. Yeah, now that's right at our apoapsis. That's better than I could have hoped for. So yeah, that'll be excellent. I do want to get my Drez periapsis closer than that, but so I'll deal with that once we get to that maneuver node. Okay, so Derlin Kerman on his way. I'll do the mid-course plane change because right now we don't really have a rendezvous with Drez, and I want to end this episode with us really on our way to Drez. So let's get there and complete this deal so that we are really on our way to Drez. Okay, it's approximately the right time. When you're talking about a 100-day orbit, 27 minutes is not too bad. Let's just get on with it. It's a long burn because we didn't even have an encounter going to it, so it is a much heftier burn than normal for a mid-course plane change. But we do have 5 degrees to adjust to, so that's another thing. Anyway, I'll catch up with you once we finish this burn. Okay, coming close to the end of this burn. We still don't have a Drez encounter really yet, so let me get rid of this node here. See if we can get one of those. Seems like it's doing this indecisive thing again. Oh, wait. I had a closest approach much closer than what it's saying right now, just a little while ago. Let me demonstrate. There we go. So maybe I should be burning in a different direction right now. Let's say Okay, I'm just gonna go with this. Heck. Aha. Right. This is all just trying things out right now. Of course, the fact that it's jittery doesn't help. Okay, that did not do good. I think that's about as close as I'm gonna get it. Right now I'm not even too sure how close that is, really. Let's time warp a bit. That tends to stabilize these nodes. So 11,000 kilometers, but we're definitely headed in for Drez. It's a little bit far compared to what I normally get things at, but Drez is very small. So, Derlin Kerman, on his way to Drez. Thanks to the valiant efforts of Merman Kerman and Wildred... Is it Wildred or Wilfred? I think it's Wildred. Wildred Kerman. We do have Wildred back now, so that's nice. I guess he really was just missing in action. We did miss him in action. He just floated away from render distance. So hopefully... Well, that's my story, and I'm sticking to it. He didn't die, he was just lost for a bit because he went out of render distance, and we have him back now, so everything is alright. On that note, thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please do press like. If you want to continue following my adventures, especially our eventual arrival to Drez, do consider subscribing, and I'll see you next time.